way of bringing down costs, you can be sure that Monty Byrne would find a way of doing it. He was quite an extraordinary character. There was nothing he wouldn't do to cut down costs. I mean, on another production, one day I had problems with an Italian crew that were threatening to go on strike. And I went to Mr. Berman for help on it. He was that time producer and cameraman. And when I explained that they'd threatened to go back to Rome unless I gave them triple money on a certain day, he looked at me very coldly and he said, call their bluff, he said. But if they go back, he said, you're fired. So, you know, you can judge from that. No, he was a very economical producer, very shrewd. And yes, he would. If he went on holiday and he could photograph something with his own cine camera that could be used in the film, you can bet your life he'd do it.
What was your favorite episode? Could you do that? Could you say?
I don't know whether because he's become so famous, but I guess the one with Donald Sutherland, which was, what was it called?
What was it?
Shadow of a Panther.
Shadow of a Panther.
Quite mad, wasn't it, with all sorts of voodoo things.
But, do you really remember, or have you been looking this stuff up?
No, I haven't. I haven't, and also I've been in the theatre.
I remember very little of it. I mean, I was watching one the other day, and I don't remember what the name of the episode was, because I only tuned in to watch a bit of it. And you were in a hotel room, and you went into the bathroom, right? And you drew back the shower curtain. And I was in there, in my suit, soaking wet. I don't remember
don't
doing
remember.
That. I don't remember doing that.
I don't remember
I thought,
that.
I thought I would remember that. You know, it must have been a very unpleasant day. I must have been wet all day. And, you know, my suit must have been sort of soaking wet and sticking to me. Don't remember it.
We were talking earlier about the ones in the very cold countries, which again were always on the set with the huskies panting. And
yes, so funny. These dogs these laying dogs. There in the snow.
It was very hot, yeah. Wasn't it?
And then sometimes, because they would orchestrate that you do three at the same time, submarine shot, you didn't know actually what the story was because you were going from set to set.
Brady. Look, I am so sorry. Will you hold on 1 second? George! George, old buddy, where you been? Been worried sick about you. 2 days without a signal and...
It's strange, isn't it? Some episodes, you were talking about the one you did with Colin Blake in The Interrogation, which was a really, really good episode, probably because I wasn't in it very much. But, but I remember the one that we did together called Auto Kill.
Murder by this man. Look at him, Richard. Look at his evil face. The face of the man who destroyed them, who murdered your father and your brother.
Again, I attacked, as I often did when invited to work on another series, I sort of attacked the premise in that I had them brainwashed into attacking each other, because I thought super beings ought to be pitted against super beings, and that was the germ of the plot.
I was being brainwashed and was I thought that you were my mortal enemy.
Right.
Remember, that was the story.
Right.
I'd been given drugs or something, or taken drugs, or be having my head shrink or something. Anyway, so we had a fight, didn't we? You
right.
and I had,
we
a,
did.
Had a fight.
We did.
So it was the first time we'd sort of fought without the stuntmen to look after us, really.
We did well, though.
We did well.
We didn't hurt each other.
No, we didn't. Do you remember the guy that doubled for me and was my stand-in? Do you remember him?
What was his name?
He looked very like me from the front, right?
Yeah.
But from the back, he had a big bum and a bald patch. And of course, you only ever saw him from the back. And it wasn't until they put all the pictures together that I realized, I always thought, he'll look really good. But of course, you never saw him from the front. And you'd see this guy waddling along with a big bum and a bald patch.
Somebody must have had it in for you because
yeah,
I mean I had a
good, you had a good guy. Didn't you?
I mean Rocky was one of
yes,
my
that's right.
what was He went on to do, I saw him in a lot of films, Rocky something and Vic Armstrong, who became one of the most famous stunt coordinators
in movies.
I'll tell you what I loved about one of the things I loved about the first episode, aside from the excitement, even though it wasn't the first one, what we wore. Mm. You remember the flight jackets?
That's right.
You know, and the pants? Yeah. I felt like such a stunt.
I know, exactly. It was real Steve McQueen stuff.
It was Steve McQueen stuff.